now that I've shown you the underside of the seat that we're getting ready to recover, I wanted to take off the cheap slip-on cover that was hiding this magnificent patch job that somebody has done in the past. They looks like they used a whole roll of duct tape, and I'm not exactly sure what else I'm going to find under here. Looks like that they had just bought some replacement type foam. And like I said in previous, that a lot of times it's not the foam's fault, it's actually the seat spring on the bottom. And where we had this one flipped upside down, we definitely saw where those were broke. So now for the dirty part of the job. So there's all different types of tools that you can use to actually get the seat cover off. We've got these handy little cutters right here. I will take the seat tracks off first. Those are very simple, just standard hex head bolts. And then I will also take off the hinge covers right here. They are also just a standard Phillips head screwdriver. These I have had to drill out a few of those just because the screws were so rusted that I stripped the heads off of them. So again, usually some kind of WD-40 or break loose type help on those, that way you don't have to wind up drilling them out. These here are awesome. All you got to do is just put them on the hog rings right here, and it takes very little effort. It's seamless or whatever, very amount of pressure, and you can just pop them right off of there. If you don't have some nice cutters like this, you can just use a standard pair of pliers or whatever and just twist it. The hog rings, a lot of times they're so rusted that they just snap off anyway. So just go around the whole entire seat, the bottom, and then on the back of the seat where they actually come together, you can take those off as well. And I'll show you a little bit more here in a second with disassembling the back from the bottom once I get these seat tracks, this covers, and all of these hog rings broke loose. We'll show you a little bit more.